also worried about you, Sonny. Why did you leave me like that?
I can explain that.
Are you all right?
Yes, of course. I'm fine.
Thank God. You know, I thought something terrible had happened. I was so afraid for you and the babe.
So I have no choice, then. I go back to Ireland tonight, or the judge will destroy Hogan, Quinn, Cagney. Now, I can't let him ruin them for my sake. So we'll go on as we have for the last 20 years, eh? Staying apart. So that together we can keep the truth from coming out.
Cat? What exactly does this card mean?
Stuff and nonsense.
Sophie gave one to each of us. She must have had some reason.
Oh, sure she did. She likes to play games, that one. It's nothing but a childish game.
Then why are you so upset?
I'm not. The only thing that's bothering me is being kidnapped.
Really? What does the card mean?
They call it the lover's card.
Oh, really? Well, then how come there's three people on there instead of two lovers?
Because it points to a time of decision. A difficult decision.
Oh, you mean the woman has to decide between the old man and the young man.
Search for Tomorrow is brought to you by new improved Zest deodorant bar. Zest lathers you clean, then rinses you cleaner. You're not fully clean unless you're zestfully clean.
Well, yes, the girl does have a choice to make. But the men in the card are only symbols. The older man, he symbolizes maturity.
And the young man, adventure, excitement, passion.
And the unknown.
Oh, I see what Sophie had in mind. The old man is Malcolm, obviously, and the young man is me.
Oh, so it's a dashing romantic hero you see in the mirror.
Yeah, well, you know if the shoe fits.
Oh, you're full of yourself, aren't you? Way too full of yourself.
All right, then you tell me. What did Sophie have in mind when she gave us the two cards?
How do I know? Maybe she's the one who's in love with you. What difference does it make what she thinks? The business about the cards is all drivel.
Is it?
Yes. And you'll be better off if you don't let Sophie's fantasies become your own.
It's no fantasy, Kat. Believe me, I wish it were. I don't want to feel what I do any more than you do. I do. I don't need this complication in my life.
Fine. Don't let it. I'm not.
Fine. I won't. Why are you trying to clean that wedding dress anyway? It's ruined.
Oh, wait. I'll have it as good as new, and I'll be wearing it when my Malcolm comes to rescue me.
I don't get it. I don't understand.
What?
You go ahead. You look me in the eye, and you tell me that you're in love with Malcolm.
You fool. Of course I love him.
Oh, really? As a lover? Are you aching to see him? Is your body and heart crying out for him?
Stop that talk.
All these nights on this boat, do you miss him in your bed?
How dare you?
I mean, when you make love to Malcolm, is it everything for you? Is it wild and sweet like they say it's supposed to be?
Don't.
Hmm? Is it?
It will be. Because I love him. I love him with all my heart. Okay, so now you know. I never made love to Malcolm and Cleary. I never made love to any man. Is that what you wanted to know? Are you satisfied?
So it's all settled, Anna. Except for one thing.
What's that?
Quinn. I'm afraid that he won't stop until he's unraveled the whole truth of what happened.
I'll take care of Quinn.
Oh, well, I pray that you can. He's on to me, you know. And he found the body. How in the world are you going to explain all that away?
I don't know yet. I'll find a way. I have to.
All right. That you do. That you do. You know, that boy is trying to reclaim a part of his life that he lost when he was a wee child. And I'm afraid that if he finds it, it'll destroy him.
Sometimes I think Quinn suffered more than any of us. Funny, but a long time ago, before this, Quinn was about 5. And I was tucking him into bed one night. He looked up at me with those great big eyes of his and he said, if there was a fire in the house, who would I save first? Cagney, Hogan, Daddy, or me? I mean, out of the blue, just like that. I didn't know what to say. I thought for a minute and then I told him that nobody would be saved first or last. That we'd all save each other. There's been a fire smoldering in this family for years, and I have yet to save Quinn.
No, no, Katie.
Don't,
Katie.
Don't.
But
I don't know why I'm acting like we've lived with this for 20 years. We'll go on and live with it for 20 more. Nothing's really changed.
No, I think you're wrong. Something has changed, hasn't it?
The girl, Kat. Now, what do you want me to do if Quinn brings her here?
I'll send someone for her.
She's your wife. You want to see her as soon as possible.
No, Katie. No, she's not my wife.
You said there was a wedding.
Aye, but Quinn stopped it before it was done.
Then you'll be wanting to take your vows soon.
Katie, darling, you must answer me one question. Why did you never come to meet me in Ireland? I wrote you, I begged for you to come. We could have started a new life there, you know. And in time, we could have explained all this mess to the boys. But why didn't you come? Why did you never give us that chance?
But I did. I went to meet you. I was there.
What's wrong?
Well, Bella, we're not alone, you know.
Liza, good to see you. You heard our news, haven't you?
I think so. I mean, you two are married. Am I right?
You're absolutely right. It's the most wonderful wedding in the world. It was crazy, but it was wonderful, right, darling?
Oh, it was crazy, all right.
We're in the middle of this revolution, and I was the happiest man in the world. It was the happiest day of my life. You know, that's quite interesting. I can't wait to tell my children about this. Our children. I can't wait to tell anybody about this.
Maybe you better hold off on that.
Maybe I'd better go.
No.
No, please don't go.
Sonny, what's going on?
Bella, we need to talk, the two of us. But first, I need some time alone to sort of get my head together. So why don't you go to your apartment and I'll come there as soon as I can, okay? I promise.
You promise you won't run off again?
I promise.
Today?
Today.
See, I can't refuse you anything. I'll be waiting. Love you, babe. Love you.
Bella.
This is incredible. Bella's actually sincere.
Bella has been a new man ever since he found out you were pregnant.
Liza, will you stop? I am not pregnant.
So you're in shock, are you? You never imagined I might be a virgin. Your mind is in the gutter.
Oh, I never thought that.
I saw the look on your face. The only bond you could imagine between Malcolm and me was lust.
No, I wouldn't think that of you, but I know the kind of man that Malcolm is.
You don't. You don't at all. He's a good, pure man.
Does a good, pure man lust after his own brother's wife?
Stop that filthy talk. Malcolm never in his life...
I have proof.
Oh, you have proof. You have proof of everything, don't you?
That's right, I do. He wrote a love letter to my mother. He chased after her while my father was still alive.
Not another word. You are talking about the man I love.
Kat, I don't want to hurt you. I never meant to hurt you.
I don't understand you. I mean, one minute you're torturing me. You're trying to tear my world apart. And the next, you're a little boy begging my forgiveness.
I don't understand you either. One minute you're so wise, the next you're completely blind to Malcolm.
I love him. And the sooner you accept that, the better for you, for all of us.
Never.
You have to. You have to accept the fact that he didn't murder your father. He never dishonored your mother. You have to erase those thoughts from your mind.
I wish I could. I wish I could erase him from my mind. I wish I could erase him from the world. I wish I could erase him from your heart.
Oh, please stop that talk.
I can't. I keep remembering the time we spent together before the wedding. I keep remembering holding you in my arms while you slept in the barn. Don't you remember?
Yes, I...
Don't you remember what a beautiful night that was? Don't you remember how perfect it felt to be together?
Why are you doing this to me?
Because my whole life, I always felt that I never belonged. But after that night, it went away. I knew where I ought to be.
I can't return your feelings.
I know that you're trying to fight how you feel. I did too. I came to Ireland for revenge, not this. The timing's all wrong, I know, but there's nothing that we can do about it
now. There is. I can't...
No, Kat. Listen to what the card is saying. It's calling out to us. Listen to what it's saying.
This is crazy. Unpack. Bring dishes and flowers to Sunny first.
Flowers, yes.
No. She said I should give her space. Flowers later. Get your suitcase.
No. First call the doctor.
Okay. No, you call the doctor.
I'll get the cigars. I mean the suitcase. You know, I didn't bring any buy any cigars.
Honey, please sit down. Sit down. I'm tired to get the cigars. I'll get the doctor.
Honey, okay? Would you just relax? We still have plenty of time.
We do?
Yes, we do. Now, come on. I want you to sit here next to me. I want you to hold with me. I love you so much. We're so lucky to have each other.
Oh, just like this. Breathe, you know. There we go. This deep breath. Oh, yes.
Isn't she beautiful?
Beautiful.
Yes, you are. You're beautiful.
Just like a mother. Made me the happiest father in the world.
Oh, look at this nice voice.
Happiest father in the world.
No, you couldn't have been, Erica. I waited for you.
Oh, I tried. I never got to the church. The judge stopped me.
The judge?
Followed me to Ireland. He thought that I'd lead him to you.
Oh, damn.
Well, he threatened me. Threatened the boys. I had to turn back.
Damn it.
I had no choice.
No. No, no, Kate. 20 years I thought you didn't come because you didn't love me anymore.
Oh, now, how could you ever have thought a thing like that? How could you ever doubt what I felt about you then?
You remember I wrote that I'd wait an hour by the church? Well, I waited an hour, and when you didn't come, I waited another hour and another. And Katie, I waited days for you, hoping against hope. I thought I was going to go mad.
I know. I felt the same.
20 years because of the judge? Oh, do you realize if I'd known it'd all be different now?
Yes.
You know why I picked that place to meet, don't you? Because that's the spot where I first realized that you were the one for me. You remember? Shall I never forget it? We went down to the sea and we walked up and down the strand all day, hardly saying a word.
You hardly said a word. I was babbling my fool head off. Well, I had to. I mean, you wouldn't speak. You'd hardly look at me. And you kept picking up those stones, throwing them into the sea, trying to see how far you could skip them.
Well, I had to. I had to do something. Otherwise, I'd have been standing there staring at you like a stoat in a bottle.
I thought you were so cocky, so full of yourself. All you wanted was to just get rid of a silly girl like me. Get off into some mischief.
Oh, no, I was scared to death. I was afraid of what I was feeling. And I was afraid that if I opened my big mouth, I'd frighten you away with my mad blather about how much... Well, I suppose that'll be the judge's man.
Yes.
Time to go to the airport. Mr. McCleary's flight leaves in less than an hour.
For gas pain and bloated feeling, Gas X has the fastest relief ingredient. Look, gas bubbles in beer. Add the leading antacid, add Gas X. Gas X got rid of the gas. Gas X has the fastest reliever for your gas pain and bloated feeling.
Holding out on your mother?
What?
You never told me Massengill Douche has Effectol.
I just bought it. Only Massengill has Effectol for effective douching any time of the month.
Massengill adds Effectol to all three fragrances for a clean, fresh feeling of gentle, effective douching.
I've always liked Massengill's more comfortable slanted design.
And only Massengill has Effectol
for effective douching any time of the month.
Trust Massengill, the leader for 74 years.
Splash, let them know that you know the way to go.
Go by canoe, doo-doo-doo. Go by canoe, doo-doo-doo-doo. Doo-doo-doo, go by canoe.
Oh, good. Worried about you. Come on and sit down.
Bella, you've got to hear me out. And you've got to believe that I'm telling you the truth. This whole...
You like them? I went shopping. Got a little girl.
Oh.
Mr. McCleary, we have to leave.
There's no going back. Not for us. You have to go on. For the boy's sake. Tell me, do you still believe in heaven?
Of course.
Then believe. I'll see you there. Goodbye, my love. Yes, this is she. Well, a telegram from Hogan McCleary. Yeah, just... I'm sorry, when did you say that flight is arriving? I see, thank you. Wait. That means Patty and Hogan will be at the airport the same time.
Time to make the choice that the card wants you to make.
Oh, no, you're out of your mind. Let me go. No, stay away from me.
Okay.
Stay away from me.
Oh.
Open this door. I'm suffocating.
Oh,
I need air.
Okay, you can't go out on the deck in the storm.
I'm suffocating. I'm going mad.
All right, all right.
Let me out.
All right. Go. You want to go? Ken.
Tonight, come home to NBC for the holidays and have yourself a very Smurfy Chipmunk time with a Smurf Christmas special at 8, 7 Central and Mountain, followed by a Chipmunk Christmas with those cut-up cuties, Simon, Theodore, and yes, of course, Alvin. Then, what can make Friday hotter than Miami Vice? Crime story on its new night, tonight on NBC.